Hello everyone, my name is Sienna Robinson, better known as the Dating Diva NJ. So just a little bit about what I do is I write dating and relationship blogs, and now I'm just putting a face and a voice to my words. So I talk about different topics that we all go through, and today's topic happens to be called It's Me or the blank blank blank. So when I get into the actual blog, you will get a little more information from that. Stop laughing, man. Alright, so let's get started. Have you ever seen the show It's Me or the Dog? Well, if you haven't, let me catch you up to speed. Animal Planet has a brilliant show where couples call on this sort of super nanny for dogs because the family pet is turning the house upside down. Usually, one of the owners wants to keep the terror and, of course, the other doesn't. What the show boils down to is too much attention to the dog and not enough on the household. So what does this have to do with relationships? Have you ever dated someone and they put everything and or anyone before you? Your partner tends to prefer hanging out with friends, working, playing video games, shopping, etc. over time spent with you. If this sounds familiar, you're not alone. There may be a few reasons why. Your partner may not realize that this is something that bothers you. Many times couples argue about one thing, but the true problem may not become uncovered until everything has boiled over. It's common for couples to start arguing about one thing and by the end of the problem had nothing to do with the initial argument. So instead of keeping your partner in the dark about feeling neglected, simply let he or she know, in a calm, understanding voice that is, that you know video game time is important, but is it possible to limit that time when you are around? Now at first your partner will jump at the opportunity to show how much this trivial game is not important, but the proof will be in the pudding. People will say what they're expected to say, so don't walk out of the room with your head held high just yet. See how long this lasts. You may have to remind your partner of the agreement. Remember to never attack them. Try to be understanding and supportive for their so-called attempt. Another approach is to get involved. Although you may not like to shop, if you are more interested in spending time with your partner, you may have to take one for the team to kill two birds with one stone, so to speak. Compatibility is very important in a relationship, but what we must realize is yes, men are from Mars and women are from Venus, but damn it, we're both here on Earth, so we have to compromise to make things work. Give your partner time to be in their own skin, and you in yours. So when you finally get together, it will be time well spent, having fun doing things that you will both enjoy. Friends, however, are a little different. You need a compromise from everyone in this case. It is sometimes very difficult to please everyone, but we must try our best to make sure everyone, including ourselves, are content. If your partner spends the majority of their time with their friends at clubs or just simply hanging out, it could be one of two reasons. One, they have not truly decided that you are the one they have fully decided to commit to because they are still committed to their way of life. Your partner may not be ready to stop sitting at their friend's house every day, all day, just shooting the breeze because it's what they enjoy doing, are used to doing, and may not realize that you could be just as fun to hang out with. The second reason could be that your partner is trying to get away from you. I know that sounds harsh, but it is possible that a person really does not like you, so they spend all their free time with people that they do like. The same goes for work. Your mate may be trying to work up the corporate ladder and has to bust their butt for the future. In that respect, you either have to support them or leave that person alone. On the other hand, it may be an escape from the slings and arrows at home. If the latter is the case, when dealing with your partner's friends and or work, you may have to read one of the posts I called when it's over. With all that said, relationships, life, cars, shoes all deal with choices. You have the choice to decide if you want to be second to anything or first to it all. Once you have given your partner a heads up about your needs, wants, and desires, they also have the choice to decide if they want to move you up the totem pole or not. Try to get involved in your partner's endeavors. The most important thing is to be supportive. Don't badger, belong. If that doesn't work, don't give the ultimatum. Get out of the relationship and find someone who will give you the attention you deserve. We all deal with people when, you know, maybe they're not that interested and we think that they really are, or they just don't even realize that, you know, you could really be fun to hang out with. So make sure it's not you or the dog. Make sure that's not your case, okay? Again, my name is Sienna Robinson, better known as the Dating Diva NJ. You can always check me out on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube, of course. And that's all / the Dating Diva NJ. So please make sure to give me your topic suggestions and your feedback. Remember, you can touch the stars if you just reach out your hand. Thank you so much. Please tune in again.